You know what?
So we can't leave it. And I've always tried to please her.
used to get up on time.
But that old man, he's a real motherfucker. Kick him on down the line. And I used to do a little bit of a water, never turn a little bit of a just kept trying to get a little bit of a little bit of a ball. I used to do a little bit of a little water, never turn a little bit of a ball. Just kept trying to get a little bit of a little bit of a ball. Mr. Brownstone, Mr. Knockin, they won't leave me alone.
Mr. Stinson says he's having a whole lot more fun since the last time he was here.
When you were young, your heart was an open book. You used to say, even lately, this ever-changing world which we live in makes you grin and cry. Say, live it, let die.
little something for 911.
For the strongest city in the world.
Yeah!
good.
Robin Fink. I'm so fucking lost. would say it was me. Might have been the whiskey, but you gave me.
Piano. And bring my treats out here. All right. Bring me something to wipe my hands on. I'll get a little light. On walk. Shine a light down on me, please. Won't you shine a light? Is Conan here tonight? Paging Conan, is Mr. Conan O'Brien here? My good friend Conan. You see, I read a little while ago that he was on a diet. And now and then, you know, you need a break from a thing like that, so I brought him some donuts. These are special Krispy Kreme Conan O'Brien dedication donuts. Here. So you can have a donut on Conan. You want a donut? Here, here's a donut. You want another donut? There you go. Have it. There you go. Here, guys here, I got a show to do. Could you take care of passing these out? It's Axel's White Trash Bistro Catering. Have some Conan donuts here. Calm down now. He won't mind, my good friend, he won't mind. He's a sport.
Thank you.
I remember when we played here or somewhere here in New York. There was a writer, I don't know if he still writes. There's a guy named John Corrales, I think it was, for the Times. You know what? I'm gonna save that story for the song that fits it most. Here's a little ditty about frustration
and oppression.
Madison, square fucking guy.
I'm gonna tell you a story.
Stand up for righteousness.
What?
Stand up for justice.
Yeah. What?
Stand up for truth.
I first grew up with all this around.
You gotta call on that something.
Where does it come from?
That can make a way out of nowhere.
All this hatred.
What we've got here is
fear.
On the upper deck, to your right, my left, on the keyboards, Mr. Chris Pittman, in the green leisure suit. On the opposite side, Mr. Dizzy Reed.
The model of perfection, Mr. Richard Fortes.
On the left, Mr. Thomas Eugene Stinson. On the drums, Mr. Brain. It's a Cadillac commercial for the Snoop DeVille. On my far left, on the guitar in the white, in this corner, Mr. Robin Fink. And from the farthest corners of the galaxy, brought to you from deep space, and left in the dark corners of a chicken coop, Mr. Buckethead. Thank you. Mr. Richard Curtis. On the piano, Mr. Dizzy Reed.
tried so hard to make you wanna make a change of mind. And it hurts too much to see you now you left yourself behind. You know I won't.
Happy birthday. They had a sign.
It was a sign from heaven. You know, I read a little review that some of these things were, they sounded a little dated. No shit. It's kind of the point, right? It's not it, isn't it? All right, let's have a little fun. I've told people that this is a reunion tour of sorts. As I managed to bring enough of myself together to be with you here tonight. We did Chicago on this leg, and we had a great time in Chicago, jam-packed with on-stage collisions and keep-on-playing kind of stuff, and it was a lot of fun. And then I read this review, and opinions are one thing. You can think it sucked. That's fucking peace, man. That's your business. That's your life. But if you're gonna lie, then you're a pussy. So, this next song we played, with
my old friends, my former friends, my thought they were, but guess they weren't, and probably never were friends.
But this guy John Perales, then he wrote a review, and I guess he must have been in the bathroom or getting a Coke or some Midol or something. Because he wrote how the crowd hated the song and everybody was bored, no one was into it. But I think he might have been able to enjoy himself. I'm not complaining now. He might have been able to enjoy himself if he'd just use a little more patience himself.
Thank you. Thank you. Take it!